Is anxiety genetic? Do the genes you inherit from your parents decide whether you suffer with anxiety or not? There has been a lot of research done on this subject, including some recent studies with some very interesting results that may change your view. But whatever your view is by the end of this video, what I want to convey in this video is an important message about anxiety. So stay tuned. One of the reasons this question has been so difficult to answer is the nature v nurture argument. A small study of families found that children with an anxiety disorder were 2 to 3 times more likely to have at least one parent with a current or lifetime anxiety disorder. This could lead you to conclude that anxiety is genetic, but this study and many others recognise that parenting may play a significant role in the development of anxiety disorders. A child learns from their parent, and if the parent's behaviour indicates that the world is a dangerous place, the child may adopt the same beliefs, behaviours, and thinking patterns. But there have been some studies suggesting certain genes or combinations of genes may play a role in susceptibility to anxiety disorders. For example, one study on generalised anxiety disorder suggested that the RBFOX1 gene may be implicated. And another study recognised that the NPSR1 gene had been associated with panic disorder in women. And genetic and epigenetic variation in the OXTR gene has been associated with social anxiety disorder. The study stated that epigenetic variation was particularly important, but what on earth is epigenetic variation? If you think of genes as an instruction book for how your body should work, epigenetic variation is like your body having a different interpretation of those instructions, which can lead to the body not reacting like it's supposed to. Epigenetic variations are caused by environmental factors. When it comes to anxiety, it is likely that stress and trauma cause these epigenetic variations. So research until recently has indicated that your genes probably do play a part, but environmental factors are probably more significant. But a very recent study goes one step further. This study looked at 5,872 people who had seen a psychiatrist for nerves, anxiety, tension or depression. It compared their genes with 43,862 people who had not reported any mental health issues. It did not find any statistically significant genetic differences between the two groups. Put plainly, they did not find any depression or anxiety genes. Another study by the University of Alberta looked at 20 years' data of numerous different diseases and concluded that DNA contributed only about 5 to 10% to the development of disease, including anxiety disorders. So the good news is that your genes are unlikely to be causing your anxiety. It's more likely that learnt behaviours and epigenetic changes caused by stressful life events are the cause of your anxiety. Epigenetic changes can be reversed, and learnt behaviours can be unlearned. So the message of this video is, your future is not dictated by your genes. You have a lot more influence on your anxiety than you realise. If you would like to understand more about the science behind anxiety, you may be interested in this video, which explains the role of serotonin in anxiety.